1, 2, 3, 4.
I woke up last night shaking from a dream. Greatest job in the world. You know, it was great before I made a record, before we made any money. I always enjoyed it, had fun, and I loved my life. Minute I began to sing, and I went down to the Elks Club, and I picked up my guitar. I remember I sang "Twist and Shout." I felt different, you know, very different. And I wished I had a tape to hear what it sounded like. Probably didn't sound very good, you know. But there was on the Elks Club in Freel, on a Sunday afternoon, they charged 35 cents at the door, and you'd go in, and there were about four or five bands. You know, some of them were really good. It was a moment when people didn't sing. I mean, no one, the self-contained band of the singers and the players didn't really exist locally. Everyone played instrumentally, you know. This was the Ventures here in the States, and it was the Shadows in England, you know. Everybody modeled themselves on those bands. And I was right at the cusp where that still existed, but then British invasion, and all of a sudden everyone began to model themselves on the Beatles or the Stones or who came afterwards. About the size of the Prince, yeah. You know, it was about, Prince held about 175 people, you know, and the bar was run by a bricklayer from Freehold, town I grew up in, and he was, he'd bought the place and he was dying. There was nobody in the place. Steve and I went down one Friday night, and we walked in, and the place was empty. There was about two people at the bar, and we said we'd had a band, and would he let us play? You know, and he says, "Well, what kind of music do you play?" I says, "Well, we play our own music, and we play what we want." You know, he says, "I don't know." He says, "Look, it's not going to cost you anything." I don't know, I don't think so. It's like, for free, he didn't want us to play. And so he conceded that, you know, we could charge a buck at the door next Friday night. And that's what we did. We went down, we charged a buck at the door. And I got saying the other night, about, I think, 15 people showed up. But it was 15 more than was in the place the previous Friday night. And so he gave us another couple of weeks, and pretty quickly we built a crowd. It was 30, and then, you know, 80 people came. And in about a month or two, we were close to filling the place three nights a week, and it was the only source of income. Original nickname was the Doctor because I had a band called Dr. Zoom and the Sonic Boom, and that basically was almost everyone in the local music scene who we got together, and it was a combination of original music, and I would hate to call it performance art because none of us had ever heard of the term at the time, but people would, like, there would be Monopoly game going on stage, and there would be other people engaged in disconnected activities that seemed to be a part of the show. But Steven was originally Miami Steve because he'd went to Miami once. and he came back and he had on a Hawaiian shirt. And he would traipse around Asbury Park in a Hawaiian shirt and a Russian, like a winter Russian hat. and Miami Steve, no one had ever been to Miami at the time. So the names came from anywhere. There was a big tiny, there was a little tiny, there was white tiny, black tiny. It was, and that was anyone who obviously wasn't tiny got that nickname. And so it came out of, and I think that my recollection was the boss was a result of the fact that I was paying everybody at the end of the week in some fashion. And it was never actually meant for public dissemination, and I personally would have preferred that it had remained private. But that's the way it goes.
Why has skin like leather and the diamond hard look of a cobra? I was born to win weather, but I burst just like a supernova. I could walk like Brando right into the sun, and dance like a Casanova. With my blackjack and jacket and ass slicks, silver star studs on my dust like a Harley and Heat. When I stuck down the street, I could feel its heartbeat. My sister's fell back, sitting on that mantle. The cripple on the corner cried out, nigga, swing a pity. And downtown, boy, sure top credit. So hard to be a saint.
Elvis evoked a world, a time and a place, and a very specific sort of world, particularly on those Sun Sessions. And you just, there's so many ghosts that get called up, you know. Even the early rock things, that's just what he did, you know. I think Hank Williams did the same, Woody Guthrie did the same, Bob Dylan did the same. The Beatles are Rolling Stones, you know, they're people who created these very, quite complex, very entertaining, pleasurable, but complicated creative pictures, you know. I was interested in doing that in some fashion, and writing about myself and my own life and in sort of presenting that to a listener, something that you could get involved in, you could really get involved in.